Hey, assistant coach, how are you guys doing? It's me, Johnny Sports, and welcome back to Road to Ronaldo's. It is happening again, and this time around, there is a lot to update you on because I didn't post this series for a couple of days because, as you guys know, I flew over to Turkey and I came back. So I missed out on one day where it was the exact day that I would have uploaded the Road to Ronaldo. So that is why we are jumping into it right now. And if you guys can smash over 1,000 likes on this video, I will have a Liverpool episode up tomorrow, or actually on the same day this video is uploaded. So double uploads for you boys. Go ahead and smash that like button. Now, in the last episode, we brought in Zlatan Ibrahimovic. And I can tell you right now, he's not in our team anymore. Squad battles, you need fast, pacey, dribbling strikers. You don't need tall, strong players like Zlatan Ibrahimovic. And I realized that after just using Zlatan for 3 games. So I sold him on straight away, got back my coins, and I brought myself a couple of amazing players into the team. Starting off at the front, Zlatan has been replaced by Marcus Rashford, who is currently worth around 40,000 coins. Just incredible amounts for a 79 rated player. 34 matches, 28 goals, 32 assists. You can tell he has played a load of matches for me already. After the last episode that you guys have seen, and he has been quite good, but Gabriel Jesus is the main man in this team. 36 matches, 39 goals, 32 assists. Now moving on from the attack, we go down a little bit and you see two new names. No more Davinson Sanchez and no more Eric Dier. The reasoning behind that is this. I had a lot of coins. I had like 150k and I decided, you know what? I need new players. I need a new defense. Players that can just catch up to my opponent's pacey strikers. And the two players that I came up with obviously had to be Virgil van Dijk and Bailly. Bailly with his 78 pace is the just basically quite physical and fast center back. And then van Dijk is the one that I look at as the more physical player on the pitch who can push off players off the ball quite easily, and he's also quite good on corner kicks as well. So those are the additions that I brought into the team. I spent around 33k on Van Dijk, 59k on Bailly, which is the highest amount for a defensive player so far, and 40k on Rashford. So big investments have been made, and because of that, I had to sell one of our ones to watch cards. And as you guys can see, last episode I asked you, should I sell on one of my ones to watch cards? And most of you guys said, no, don't sell Aurier. Please don't sell him. I have a lot of comments considering that as well. So Aurier has not been sold. But Davinson Sanchez, after thinking about it for a little while, I thought, you know what? It's probably unlikely that he will get a name for him. Aurier moves forward a lot. He could get himself a goal and assists as well. So I'm expecting him to definitely get an inform in the future. Right now, I think he's banned from a plane because he had a red card, but he will be back soon. And then we can wait for him to get a new inform. Currently, he's worth around 60k coins. Just letting you guys know in advance. Now let's get into some of the comments that we had in the last episode. Now here's one of the comments that really caught my eye. It is from Mohamed Varsame. He says, I know this is most about squad battling. Would people like it if Johnny would attempt FUT Champions like so Johnny can see? Yes, I have qualified for FUT Champions and I will play this weekend completely because they have extended it to Monday, which is perfect for me. So I will play my 40 matches. The first 10 matches, I got myself 6 victories, 4 losses. The losses that I had, I could have won 2 of those matches. 2 of those losses were deserved, but the other 2, I was quite upset that I lost. But at the end of the day, the weekend league is also a very good way of getting in coins, and what I'm aiming for is gold 2. Gold 2 would be incredible. Hopefully I can get it done. Today, we will have some FUT Champions gameplay. Wish me luck, boys. Hopefully I don't get destroyed. Let's get this one started. Oh, and also one more thing that I need to mention is that I did trade a little bit. I made around 30,000 coins, I believe. Are you actually kidding me? I kept these 56 players on my transfer list for so many days. I did not clear it. And now, while I'm recording this, I pressed it on accident. Are you joking, mate? Okay, I can tell you what I did. I went after gold players, non-rare golds in big leagues, and players that were put onto the market for 400 coins, and I sold them on for up to 2,200 coins, and that really helped me out to get some coins back into my club because I did a few SBCs. Before we get into these matches on FUT Champions, take a look at these packs that I got myself. I haven't shown you the players that I got so far on purpose, so go ahead, take a look at the inform and the man of the match that I packed. Let's get into the favorite part of everyone who watches Ultimate Team content. It is the pack opening, and I made a couple of these SBCs in order to get two rare players packs. The first one was Atiba, so I just skipped it. The second one wasn't boards as well, so I was just disappointed, and the players that came out of it were just terrible. And then on the third one, we finally are getting ourselves boards, and on this one it is a goalkeeper Spanish. I thought the Gea for a second, but then it was Iker Casillas. But also in the pack we had another great player, which is Fabinho. So if I ever go over to the French league, I will have a decent CDM. And now it's time for the inform. Who are we getting? It is going to be the Australian legend Tim Cahill, who has once again scored goals for his nation, and he is just a ridiculous player, man. He still hasn't stopped playing football. That really surprises me. And then going on, I told you guys that I packed a man of the match. Yeah, you will see it in just a second, but the issue is that I did not record that pack. So now you get to see the player that I packed. The man of the match that I got myself is, hold on, we gotta change the filter. Ah, suspension. Now we are moving over to special, and you see him down the right. Yeah, not the best. That was a little bit disappointing. I was hoping for a Messi, and I got myself a Torres, not even Fernando Torres. So after you have seen the packs that I've gotten, yes, it was sadly none of those big names that you were expecting. Sadly, I thought, oh my god, I'm about to get Messi, and it didn't work out. But here you can see, this is our first opponent today on FUT Champions. Wish me luck, boys. I really hope I'm not about to get triggered. Yes, pass it, Gabriel. Into Danny Rose. Danny Rose cuts back inside, plays a pass into Dele Alli. Rashford, that's the first goal. Okay, 14th minute, we take the lead in the first match right here. Hopefully I can get to 21 victories, man. I really hope so. At least 18, that's the goal. We need to get gold 3 at least. I would love to get myself gold 3 rewards this month at least. That would be nice, because I think you get like, what, 3 red informs or something? So that would be quite nice. Oh, Roque Mesa. Look at them skills. This guy doesn't even know what's going on. Dele Alli, nice turn. Finish it, son. Dembele. Ref, that's a pen. Okay, we do get a pen in the 23rd minute. It would be nice if I could get a rage crit right here. But I'm terrible at penalties, so wish me luck, boys. Wish me luck. Okay, yes, it's 2-0. That's a great start into the FUT Champions day. Oh, and that drag back move is just ridiculously good. Look at that. Rashford, that's the third goal. Terrible goalkeeping, but that is a pause coming in from our opponent. Thank you very much. Please quit the game. Rage quit incoming. 1, 2, 3. Voila. Yes, perfect timing. Thank you very much. First game, rage quit. Rashford coming in with how many goals? 3 goals. Not too bad. Now after that first game, I want to ask you guys a question. Who should I save up for? Should it be Kante for Mesa? Or should it be Eriksen for Dembele? If I do bring in Eriksen, I would put Dele Alli at centre midfield, put Dembele onto the transfer market. We could make some coins with him. I believe he still goes for over 30k. So let me know. Do you want to see Eriksen, or do you want to see Kante in my team, or do you want to see Dembele replaced, or Roque Mesa, who is currently my favorite player basically in this team? He's such a beast, but obviously Kante will be even better probably. So let me know, boys. That would be very interesting to see. Comments down below. help me out. Apparently our next opponent has a lot of coins. He has Dybala, Mertens, Inform, Pjanic, Matuidi, Chiellini, Buffon, but Cancelo down the right-hand side. Not really one of the best players to use. Lukaku might be fast and might be strong, but also not the most agile and not the best at defending, so we might have a chance here. Rashford, I wanted to say, but it is Gabriel Jesus on the run. Gabriel Jesus! It's a shot that gets deflected off the defender. Can we get a header in from the likes of Van Dijk? Van Dijk, left footed, Dele Alli, yes, what a terrible goal, but I'll take it. In the 13th minute, Dele Alli, the captain of this squad, with the weirdest celebration out of all, but I'll take it. Lukaku, I told you, he's not the best defender, he should have done better in that position. Pjanic, ooh, okay, that's an interesting one that we got. Oh my god, what a pass. Please make it happen. That is an incredible pass. Dele Alli. Pinpoint accuracy there. That is ridiculous. Rashford, 2-0 up against our opponent. Could we get another rage quit? That would be nice, man. Come on, make it happen. Oh, yes. Rage quit. Rage quit. Rashford, that's the thing that I don't like about him. Sometimes he just aims so far past the goal. It's just... it's terrible. I should have probably tried like a driven finesse shot near post there. That could have maybe been something that could have worked. Oh, that could be a goal. And it will be. It will be. Yeah, it's 2-1. My defense was completely out of position. As soon as we lost the ball, I knew this could be a goal for our opponent. And that kind of cancels out the fact that we could have gotten a rage quit here. Gabriel Jesus sends Rashford on a run. It kind of does work out here. Rashford, please, this time. Dele Alli! Yes, okay. Whew. Okay, that was tough. But we got another one in. One more, he could rage quit. Let's make it happen, please. Let's not concede anymore. I push us forward. We can't be losing the ball right now. Gabriel! That's what I needed. 4-1, please, rage quit now. Press that stop button, mate. I love the fact that it pops up on the top. That's a good thing that they have done. I really like that. That just gives me a feeling of, okay, he will stop and he will probably make some changes or rage quit quite soon. This guy is now starting to skill around a little bit. Interesting. Not really helping him, is it? What is he doing? What is this guy doing? I mean, come on. Stop it, mate. Dele Alli. 5-1. Okay, it seems like I'm on a good form today. I did not expect to get 2 victories on camera as well. So, for that, give me some props. Give me some props, man. I genuinely am not an online player. I'm not the best. I'm just average. Just maybe a little bit above average because I play FIFA every day. But, man, it feels good to get victories on the weekend league and feel very comfortable. I just hate losing on the weekend league. That's my main thing that I don't like doing. It just rages me out way too much. And then when I have players like this who just give up and instead of rage quitting, just stay in the game, that once again takes away the happiness from me. And it is done. 2 games, 2 victories. Hey, that's not too bad, man. 8 victories out of what? 12 matches? That doesn't sound too bad. I couldn't do an episode without opening a 2 rare gold players pack on camera. I freaking love these packs and they have been quite good to me so far, but I'm still looking for that one very special player and hopefully this time around we can get it. I spent around 4,000 coins in order to get these players into my team. And now we can open this pack right here. Give me boards, EA. That'd be much appreciated. Can we get some boards? We do. It's an inform. Spanish? Right back? Yes, I see that. Odriozola. Hey, you know what? I'm not mad at all. That is actually quite good. I mean, he hasn't really got the best physical stats or anything, but he has 86 pace. And he is an inform, so that is our second untradeable inform. Who is behind him, though? Wijnaldum! Yes, that's a great pull! Hey, this is an amazing 2 players pack. This is actually really, really good. If you guys are not doing these two players packs, do them. They are completely worth it, 100%. Ronaldo, I can just put into my team straight away. He could play instead of Messi if I wanted to. But Messi is on the same rating as Ronaldo, and I freaking love him. So Ronaldo will go onto the bench of my team. Now, in terms of squad battles, you can see me right here, still in Elite 1. I have still 4 games to play, and then I can still update my opponents. And even though I missed out on 4 matches, I am still in Elite 1. That just tells you that I've had amazing games so far. I have currently a point ratio of 2,560 points per game, I think. Something like that. I looked at it before I played my last 4 matches. It should still be up there. It might have even improved even more. And I did take a look at it mathematically. If I did continue the way that I was playing my matches so far, which was amazing, I would be right here somewhere. Number 20 or number 19. And that is really upsetting. Just because I missed out on one day where I was in Turkey, I sadly cannot be a top 100 player. And that really bothers me. I mean, if I do win these games that I have ahead of me, which are 8 games, that would get me up by at least 22,000 points. That gets me to 74,000 points. And that is so close to top 100. I mean, look at that. That's just so close to top 100. And that really bothers me. Even though I have 4 games less, I could have been in top 100. But it's not going to work out, obviously. The list will update and it will be maybe 77,000 that you will need in order to get into top 100, I guess. But currently, we are looking quite well. And I think we will be getting 2 mega packs again alongside of 40,000 coins, which you will probably see in the next episode. Now, here's one thing that I need to mention to you guys. I am not going to be playing any online season this year because the main reason behind that is squad battles takes enough time out of my day. Every day I have to play at least an hour in order to get those 4 games in. And if I also had to play online seasons, I don't know if that's worth it. So maybe later on in the year when we have already amazing team and really good setup already, we can go to Division 1. We can do like a road to Division 1 type of thing. But right now, I don't feel like it's worth it. But hopefully in the next episode, you guys will get to see me in the Gold 2 section. That would be quite nice. I would love to pick up 21 victories. Currently, our ratio is not looking too bad, but I have had enough times on Weekend League where I did well, and then all of a sudden, I played against 5 incredible opponents, and then I completely lost out. So next episode, you guys will get to see me getting my final FUT Champions matches in, and of course getting my squad battles rewards, who have been incredible so far. Now, again, if you guys don't remember from the start of the episode, please let me know, who should I replace? Should it be Dembele and then bringing in Eriksen, or should it be bringing in Kante for Messi, or maybe one more thing that you might want to think about, bringing in Lacazette if I can get some good rewards and I sell on players like Rashford and maybe also Aurier, if I have to, I could get myself Lacazette. So it all depends on the players that we get. Hopefully the squad battles rewards will be quite nice as they have been in the past. I would love to get myself a Lacazette up top, but so far Rashford hasn't been bad or anything. He has been quite solid, and I'm thinking about it, if he's worth it or not. Sometimes his shooting doesn't really feel that good, but yeah, man, we will see how that goes with Rashford. But just let me know, should it be Eriksen or Kante for the team first, and then Lacazette might be happening. I also have him as a lone player just to go ahead and test him out, which I will do in the upcoming squad battles matches, so don't you worry about that. That is going to be it for today, though. Thank you guys so much for watching. Hope you guys are looking forward to the next episodes coming in. They will be more consistent now, again, now that I am at home and I don't have that much to do apart from uploading videos. So yeah, thank you so much for watching. Have a nice day. Take care. Peace.